Hi, it's Dr. Z. I'll be discussing the etiology of anxiety, obsessive-compulsive disorder, and trauma and stressor-related disorders today. By the end of this video, you'll be able to describe the biological and psychological perspectives related to the development of these disorders. Please feel free to pause the video at any time to take notes. Now, what causes an anxiety disorder? How do these disorders develop? The word etiology is just a fancy word for cause or the origin of a disorder. Thus, we are curious to find out how anxiety disorders develop. Please recall that there are seven different perspectives in abnormal psychology. The etiology of disorders will arise from any one of these seven perspectives. Now, there are two paths a psychologist can take when determining the potential cause of an anxiety disorder. One path focuses on the biological perspective, and the other focuses on the psychological perspective. Each perspective can be separated into more specific causes. First, the biological perspective on abnormal behavior focuses on the role of genetics, family history, neuroanatomy, and neurobiology. There are three specific causes that have a biological basis for anxiety disorders. The first specific biological cause is related to family and genetic studies. The specific etiology indicates that anxiety disorders may be inherited, which is the concept of heritability. Family and twin studies indicate that if a parent or a sibling has an anxiety disorder, the child is more likely to have one too. There's also a possibility that specific genes exist that influence vulnerability. In humans, studies have identified chromosomal regions that may be important. What may be inherited is a general vulnerability factor, or trait anxiety. The film Little Miss Sunshine is an example of a family with a history of mental illness and substance abuse. The second specific biological cause is related to neuroanatomy. Different areas of the brain may be associated with different disorders. Certain brain structures seem to be correlated with social anxiety disorder and OCD. Additionally, brain functioning appears to be different when comparing control samples and individuals with certain types of anxiety disorders. Lastly, neurotransmitters may play a role in the development of anxiety disorders. The levels of the neurotransmitters serotonin and GABA may be correlated with feelings of anxiety. The film Prozac Nation is an example of a young woman who seeks out antidepressants to cope with her depression and anxiety. The third specific biological cause is related to temperament and behavioral inhibition. Jerome Kagan proposed the concept of behavioral inhibition to explain children who withdraw from or fail to approach new people, new things, or new situations. Research studies indicate that children who exhibit behavioral inhibition are more likely to show anxiety reactions and to develop childhood anxiety disorders. The film, The Perks of Being a Wallflower, is an example of a high school student who's introverted and withdrawn from the world around him. Second, the psychological perspective on abnormal behavior arises from several different approaches, such as psychoanalytic, behavioral, cognitive, and humanistic. There are three specific causes that have a psychological basis for anxiety disorders. The first specific cause is related to psychodynamic theories of fear acquisition. Recall that psychoanalytic approaches focus on the unconscious as a source of abnormal behavior. Sigmund Freud believed that our personality had three parts, the id, ego, and superego. And psychoanalytic theory believes that generalized anxiety is a result from this conflict. Defense mechanisms of repression and displacement may play a role in the development of phobias. The film Analyze This is an example of a man who witnessed the murder of his father at a young age and later develops anxiety when triggered by a similar event. The second specific cause is related to behavioral theories of fear acquisition. Recall that the behavioral approach focuses on an individual's learning history, and thus abnormal behavior is a result of maladaptive learning experiences. Classical conditioning may lead to a conditioned fear or avoidance response, similar to the case of little Albert. Observational learning, or vicarious conditioning, may lead to a conditioned fear response upon witnessing or observing a traumatic event. Informational transfer may occur when a person instructs someone that a certain object or certain situation should be feared. Parents do this all the time in simple scenarios to protect their children. The film What's Eating Gilbert Grape is an example of a mentally disabled young boy who develops a conditioned fear response. The third specific cause is related to cognitive theories of fear acquisition. Recall that the cognitive perspective views abnormal behavior as a result of distorted cognitions or distorted ways of thinking. Aaron T. Beck's cognitive theory focuses on automatic negative thoughts. He hypothesized that anxiety is a result of maladaptive thoughts of an ambiguous situation being automatically interpreted into a negative way. In other words, when someone does not text you right back, you make the automatic negative assumption, this person is upset with me. The fear of fear model is a cycle where an individual gets caught worrying or fearing about when the next symptom of anxiety will occur, which then keeps them constantly on edge and anxious. Anxiety sensitivity is the belief that anxiety symptoms will result in negative consequences, such as illness, embarrassment, or even more anxiety. Now, cognitive theories of fear acquisition may also be a form of maintenance of the anxiety disorder. In other words, the distorted cognitions related to the source of the anxiety actually keep the anxiety going. Here, the film Matchstick Men is an example of a man who has a variety of distorted thoughts that are maintaining his symptoms of agoraphobia and OCD. In summary, there are two broad perspectives on the etiology of anxiety disorders, and each perspective is valuable in guiding the future treatment of your client. The photos used in this video are property of the above-mentioned films. Thank you.